grainy dirt floor, his tongue smoothed by days of tears. I lie with the women of my family. A quiet vigil. Together, we companion the dead. We comfort each other with our closeness. Grief cloaks us silent, my husband's stillness. For 3 years, he has lived little, weakened, overcome by a greater life force. The men surround and tend the outside fire, guard against wild beasts and wizards who might pluck out his soul. We wash between fingers across the graying skin of his chest, his cold body. Cold as my body must be for 40 days. Together we were like millet in sunlight. The beer is a jeweled memory, brewed spicy amber. I place a cup in the corner of the room. Day 2. We rise before dawn to carry his body along a zigzag path into the wooded grove. Spreading trees silhouette indigo against the creeping eastern sky. All the sorcerers are asleep. My forehead sweats under the headband made from the hem of his blue shirt. We wash our hands in water, sweetened by yellow star and aloe. Gone. Dust of the graveyard. We feast on roasted goat, jima, cassava. The beer warming my cold tongue. His chair is empty, save for the tied bundle of clothes. Tomorrow, they will shave my head. Day 3. In the orange prickle of morning, my broom catches small pebbles, threads, a matchstick, dust and spirits chased out of the house, blooming in clouds. The patina settles on my naked scalp. I touch no one. No one touches me. Chill spreads outward, despite the afternoon's heat. Aroma of wet animal rises from the blanket I have washed clean of his spirit. Day 4. We return to the graveyard to speak with the ancestors. Flitting shadows pattern the arid earth. I ask them for release and rest. Fill a bottle with cool soil from his quiet grave. My husband lives as our latest ancestor, protecting us, waiting for his new body. I rub my stiff stubble called comfort, empty anger. Curse the unseen that took him.